My name is Manish and you are welcome to our channel Genius Prep. So in this video we are going to talk about the word problems. Word problems are not a different kind of problems. It is the same concept, everything is same. Only thing is in the question you will see a wordings and the combination of wordings in which you need to understand what they are saying, and you have to connect all those relations which is mentioned in the question and make a equation and solve it. That's it. It's not a different question, different concept, anything. It just you need to understand. But there are many four kind of problems or topics you will see in the word problem. That is, first is price and quantity, age problem, distance and distance problem, and the fourth one is a work problem. Okay, so guys, so in this video I will be taking some example and teaching you how to do that. I will tell you what part of question you should focus to solve this kind of problems. Okay guys, a lot to know, a lot to discuss. But before we begin, please guys, do not forget to subscribe our channel, share this video, like this video, click on the bell icon, and you can follow us on the Facebook page. Okay guys, start with the very first question of topic called price and quantity relationship. Okay, so let's discuss. It's also, you can say this is a distance problem, but all of these problems will be the similar. So it doesn't matter whether it's a price and quantity. I will be taking all the examples. So this one is not price and quantity. This is the distance problem, rate, time and distance. Okay, so first question says Bob breaks up 220 miles trip into three parts. Okay, if the first part of the trip is 20 miles longer than the second part of the trip. Okay, this is our first equation. Okay, and the third part of trip is 50 miles longer than the second part of the trip. This is the second equation. How many miles was second part of the trip? Okay, so you see we have wordings for the two equations, and we have one common part in both equations is second part. Suppose second part is S. Okay, so what is equation first is, if the first part of the trip is 20 miles longer than the second part. So first part is this, it is longer than 20 miles from the first part, for second part. Okay, and the third part of this trip is T is third, is 50 miles longer than the second trip. The second trip is S and it is 50 miles longer. Okay, so we need to find out how many miles was there for the second. We need to find out the S. Okay, so but we know from the very first line the total trip length is 220 miles. So 220 is equal to first part, second part and third part. What we will do, we will replace F here, replace T here and find out the S. So 220 is equal to S plus 20 plus 20, sorry, again S plus 50. This is the first part, this is the second part, this is the third part. You combine all of them. So here we see 3S plus 70 is equal to 220. Okay, 3S is equal to 150, S is equal to 50 miles. So the answer is second part is 50 miles longer. Okay guys, so I hope you understand what we did here. We have an equation, we made the equation. First equation is this, second equation is this, third equation is this. So you see, always remember, if you have three equations, if you have three variables to solve that whole question, you need three equations. So here we have three variables F, S, T, and we have three equations 1, 2 and 3. Okay, so this is a very simple and it's a good question. And now the second question, this is, I can say this is a price and quantity. Okay, so what is second question says, a certain store sells only shirt and ties. The price of shirt is $40 and the price of tie is $20. If Bob pays $340 for 10 items from the store, how many shirt did he purchase? Okay, so here we have two different variables. First is shirt, so we can say total number of item are 10. So we can say S plus T is equal to 10. This is our first equation. What is the second equation? S is what? S is the number of shirts. T is number of tides. Okay, now it says the Bob pays $340 for 10 items. So suppose 340 is the total item he paid, but how many shirt he bought, we do not know. And what is the price of shirt, we do not know. We can say it is 40, sorry, shirt price is 40. So S cross 40 plus T cross 20. This is the second equation, right? What is the what we need to find? We need to find how many shirts. So we need to find S. So now you can see we have two variables and we have two equations, right? So there is no big deal to solve this. So we solve this second equation. Zero, we can take common and it can cut out. Okay, 340. I did it directly. If you want to solve it, what you can do, you can put the T value in this equation and you can solve the whole algebraic equation, linear equation, and you find the equation. I'm just trying to resolve this equation in lesser terms. So now we have 34 is equal to 4s plus 2t. Again, we have everything can be divided by 2. Okay, so we divide by 2, 2 and 2, what we get? 17 is equal to 2s plus t, right? Now we have first equation versus s plus t is equal to 10. So t is equal to 10 minus s. We can put that value here. So we get 17 is equal to 2s plus 10 minus s. Okay, so we left s plus 10. Okay, and it's 17, then s is 7. So total number shirt he purchased is option E, 7. I know if you are confused how I cut this zero, it's just you take common, like if take common 10, if you take common, because 10 is we can 10, if you take common and you can cut this out. If you are thinking it's not the right way, if you are getting confused, you don't need to solve this. You just put value t value from there to the equation number second. Okay, so this is the second question we did. This one is for the price when how to connect all the relations. Okay, now guys, this is second type of question. You will see the age problem. Age problem, I have seen that it's really little difficult. If we compare all of them, age problem is always little more difficult because you get confused when it's talk about current age. Age after 5 years, before 10 years, something like that's always get confused. So, but yeah, it's not that hard. We can easily get over it. Okay. So like what says, third question is the height of a tree increased by X feet each year. Okay. At the start of a certain year, the height of the tree is 100 feet. If the height of the tree is 60 feet after 8 years, what is the value of X? This is very simple. You know, because every year increasing by X, okay, we have number initial height of the tree 10 feet, we have final height of the tree, we have total number of years. Okay, what is the value of X? So what we'll do, we have 10 years, so total increment in height delta H means what was the first height and what was the last height. So 60 minus 10, total number of height increase of feet of tree is 50 feet. How many years? Okay, time is 8 years. So how many, what is the value of X? So what, now we know the year, we know how much it increased, so we can say how many how many feet it increase every year. So what we need to do X is equal to number of feet divided by t, which is 6.25 years. Oh, sorry, feet. So very initially it was just 6.25 feet. The next year it increased. First year it was 10 feet. Then it increased by 6.25 every year. After 8 years, the total height of this tree become 100 feet. So you see, whenever you see this kind of question, you need to find what is the variable we need to find and what the equation we can make to get that variable. Okay, so here we go with the fourth question, and this is, it says Virchak 6 years older, he would be double the Bob age. Jack is currently 1 year older than Bob. how old is Bob? Okay, it's again, you can see here we have two equation, two variables, you can solve it. Okay, so first is, let's talk about this one. Jack is currently 1 year older than Bob. Jack, suppose Jack age is J, it is older, 1 year older, so Bob is B, 1. Okay, this is our first equation. Now what is our second equation? What, Jack 6 year older, so Jack is J plus 6 is equal to, he would be double the Bob age. So Bob age is B, double the is 2B. We got two equations. What we will do, how old is Bob? So we need to find the B. So we need to replace J here. So we can put J value from first equation to second equation. So we can say B plus 1 is equal to, B plus 1 plus 6 is equal to 2B. We can cut this out, or you will, if you take this B here, it sends a sign. So we have Bob and it is 7. So the age of Bob is 7 years. Okay guys, this is how we solve the age and age problems. Okay, so this kind of question you will see in exam a lot. Okay, so next we move to distance problem, and this is a different, another kind of problem you see in the exam and you will see very frequently. Okay, so how we solve this, let's take an example. So always remember, distance problem is rate into time is equal to distance, or you can say, you always remember the formula, like speed multiplied by time is equal to distance. Means if a car or anything is running with this rate for this time, it will cover this much distance. Okay, always remember, whenever you see this kind of question, you need to make sure the units you are using are same for all the aspect. Okay, how, what is I'm talking about, we will see this thing in our next question. Okay, so fifth question says, Sarah goes on 600 miles trip. So means length is, distance is 600 miles. Okay, she travels a constant rate of 50 miles per hour for first 300 miles. So first part of trip is, she drove 50 miles per hour for 300 miles. Okay, and at the constant rate of, and then at a constant of 100 miles per hour for last 300 miles. Second part of this trip is, she is driving 100 miles per hour for 300 meters. Okay, what is the Sarah's average speed in per hour for the entire trip? So here you will see that she drove 300 miles with 50 miles per hour, 300 miles with 100 miles per hour. So what most people will do, because it's the same distance she is covering, she will try to take the average of these two distance. So it will be around 75 miles per hour. And you see here we have this option in this question. But remember, never ever do average of speed. If you do that thing, you will always get the wrong answer. Sometimes you may get the right answer, but not always. So it's better to avoid this concept that do average. Okay, why? Because when she was driving for 50 miles per hour, she drove 300 miles. So how many hours she was driving? So time is equal to, you see, speed multiplied by time is equal to distance. Time is equal to distance divided by speed. So that is equal to 300 divided by 50, that is equal to 6 hours. So part one, she was driving at 50 miles per hour for 6 hours, and then in the second part, she was driving for 300 divided by 100 is equal to 3 hours. So total number of hours she spent for this whole trip is 9 hours. So from here we can find the average speed or rate is equal to distance divided by time. So what is that? It is, distance is how many miles? 600 miles divided by time is 9 is equal to how many? So 60 is like 200 divided by 3, because you take 3 common and you can cut this out 300. So you see, either you can solve this or you see there is an option for this with this fraction. So answer is A. Okay, so this is a very important thing to know, that never ever do the average of speed. Always try to bring everything in time and distance and then find out the average of the speed. Okay, so now, okay guys, so we have a 6th question, and this is again related to distance. Okay, so what it says, it says Bob and Jack is starting Bob and Jack is starting at same rate, at constant rate in the same direction. Like Bob is here, Jack is here, traveling the same direction. If Bob rate is 2 miles per hour greater than Jack, so Bob speed is more than Jack by 2 miles per hour, after how many hours will Bob and Jack will be 50 miles apart? So we need to find the time. Okay, when you need to find the time, you have to make all the equation in terms of time. Okay, so we know the rate multiplied by time is equal to distance. Okay, distance is not the same, rate is different, time is constant. So what we will do, we will first find out, okay, is we both started, Bob is running with a B, this he is running with a J plus, means he is running with a J. Okay, so how many miles every hour they are separating by 2 miles. Suppose if he is running with 10 miles per hour, what Jack is running with 10 miles, so Bob is running with 12 miles. So after every hour, Bob will be 2 miles ahead than Jack, right? So in 1 hour, how many miles they will be for? 2 miles. After 2 hours, how many miles will be there? 4 miles. Okay, so how many miles we need to find time when they will be apart by? 15 miles. So what we'll do, 15 miles divided by 2, which is 7.5 hours. Okay, see, there are several ways to solve this kind of question. I'm just telling you, use some logic. Don't even, I just solved this because I just wanted to show you something, but you do not need to do this. You see, difference between both are 2 miles per hour. 50 miles they have to cover. So speed is this, distance is there, they have to time. So time is this, distance is 50 miles and 2, that is 7.5 hours. Okay, so that's another way we can solve this kind of question. Okay guys, so now we have a 7th problem, and this problem related to work problems. Work problems are similar as a distance problem, but in this kind of problem we need to evaluate how many, like you will see, one person is doing with this rate, second person is doing this rate, how much how many hours they will take to come if they work together. So this is a very typical kind of question comes under this work problem. So let's see, take an example and see how to solve this kind of question. So it says, a working at a constant rate, a certain hose can fill a pool in 10 minutes. Working at a different constant rate, another hose can fill the same pool in 15 minutes. Okay, we have two pool hose. One is filling at 10 minutes, second is filling at 15 minutes. If the two hoses work together but independently to fill the pool after it's all half full, how many minutes it will take to the hose to fill the pool? So whenever you see this kind of question, when one person is doing this, one person is doing in this minute, if they combine work together, how many time it will take? Okay, always first you need to find the rate. Okay, what does it mean? So first is H1 rate is rate multiplied by time is equal to work. Okay, so work, so H1 work, we can say H1 work. Okay, so first we need to find the rate of H1 is equal to work divided by T. Here work is 1 divided by T is 10 minutes. Okay, so this is the rate that whose one is filling the pool. Similar way, rate H2 we will find, work is 1, time is T, that means 1 by 15 is a rate, okay, when a hose 2 can fill the pool. So this is the rate 1 and rate 2. Now when they are saying both of them are working together, whenever you have both are working together, what you will do, you will combine, you will add those rates. So total rate will be 1 by 10 plus 1 by 15 is equal to 30 is the LCM. Then you take 3 plus 2, 1 by 6. So what is the new rate when both are working together? 1 by 6. But now, again, we use this formula to find the time, the how many minutes it will take. Rate is already given 1 by 6. Time we need to find out. Now, work. Okay? Remember, this equation says the pool is already half full. That means they have to work only for half amount. So T is equal to 1 by 6 multiplied by T is equal to 1 by 2. Then T is equal to 6 divided by 2. That is equal to 3 minutes. Okay, so option A. Got it? This is a very simple. Remember this concept. Whenever you have this, find out the rate, add the rate, and see what the equation says, and use the same formula for finding out the time. Okay. Now this is the 8th and the final practice question for this session. Okay, and this says working alone at a constant rate, Bob can mow one lawn in 3 hours. Working alone at a constant rate, Jack can mow one same size lawn in 8 hours. If Bob and Jack work together independently at their respective constant rate, how many hours it will take to mow half as the same size of lawn? This is a similar question what we practiced just before it. Same. I would say try this by yourself. I am solving here. Okay, you can pause this video and you can solve this, and then we will see what is your answer. Okay, pause this video. You can pause this video and solve this question. So I hope you did it by yourself and you got the same answer what I did here. Okay, it's 12 by 11. What we did, Bob rate is 1 by 3, Jack rate is 1 by 8. We add them together, and then 8 by 3 by 24, 11 by 24 is the rate for their work. Then we use the same formula, rate multiplied by time multiplied is equal to total work. Okay, then rate, time, work is already done. So half, so 12 by 11 is the 12 by 11 hour is the answer for this question. Okay guys, so I hope you like this video and you understand the concept. I know it little fast video, but in the exams you have to understand, you have to do everything very fast in accurate way, and this is what I always try to do in my video, to do everything little fast so you also understand how to solve the questions in that way. Okay guys, so I hope you like this video, you learn a lot. If you have any question, you can comment me back, you can follow us on the Facebook page, you can write me down. If you need any, if you don't understand any concept, I can make a video and help you out. Okay guys, thank you guys to watching this video. Till then, bye bye.